I developed a passion for process safety almost 20 years ago, and in fact it was like many people who are entering this discipline, it's following an accident that occurred in my previous company, Home Poulenc, where basically we had a terrible runaway reaction in the pilot plant, which killed one of my colleagues. And once you have seen that in your life, you will never forget. So that was the origin of my interest for the discipline. I'm myself originally a chemical engineer, and I've been working in that process safety discipline since then, with a strong focus, of course, on learning from incidents. I have been always interested by this topic because we definitely see that Trevor Kletz used to say that organizations have no memory, but I would even add that individuals seems to have no memory as well, because a lot of incidents, a lot of process safety incidents that we still see in 2018 or 20 years after are in fact almost the exact same situation that some accidents that occurred 25, 30 or 15 years ago. Yeah, just to exemplify that we are definitely not learning. Just last week in France, in the outskirts of Strasbourg, we experienced a terrible grain silo dust explosion, which injured four people and three are still at the hospital. When I saw that in the news, I directly thought of what happened in 97 in Blaye, in the outskirts of Bordeaux, in a very similar grain dust explosion, which killed 11 people. And even with the ATEX regulation, the regulatory framework, which is basically covering the explosion risk in an industrial facility, it seems that we are not learning. So, of course, the key question is what should be done to improve the situation and to be able to learn more from incidents. So for me, of course, there are different things that need to be done, but the most important one is obviously to educate and educate again. It's clear that people are not reading enough. There are a lot of books talking about incidents, describing incidents, and they tend to be forgotten. There are a lot of resources available, databases there and there in corporation or online or in national languages that are worth exploring and grouping. So everything that there is an immense leverage possible using all those pieces of information and sharing them among the wider process safety community, so that we can hope to finally drastically reduce the number of process safety events that are still occurring in the process industries.